the clutch has a specific purpose. It will engage the engine with the gearbox or disengage the engine power with the gearbox. So engaging and disengaging the power is to be performed by the clutch. It will just behave like a switch. When you just switch on the switch, the power is to be transmitted. When you switch off the switch, then the power is to be disconnected. So the clutch is having the same purpose. In the vehicles, so we have one clutch pedal. When we just press the pedal, the clutch is disengaged. When we do not press the pedal, the clutch is engaged. That means the power is to be transferred from the engine to the gearbox when we disengage, when we press off the clutch. When we press the clutch, then power is disconnected. So these are the power. Now we will see where the clutch is actually located. So this is the engine, and this one is the gearbox. In between the engine and gearbox, there is a device that is nothing but this is called the clutch. And this clutch is basically utilized for on and off purpose of the power. Okay. Now this clutch is of the various type. We will discuss in the further slides. It is sometimes it is called the dry clutch, it is the grip clutch, sometimes it is the cone clutch. Now this is the location of the clutch, where it is basically it is to be situated in the automobile frame of reference. So this one is the engine, and this one is the flywheels, and after that the clutch is to be mounted. Thereafter the gearbox are there, then propeller shaft, and then there is the rear wheels. So these are the clutch. As far as the type of the clutch is to be concerned, there are various type of clutch. Basically it is to be classified into two category. One is called the positive clutch, or sometimes it is called the jaw clutch or the clock clutch, or there is another type of the clutch that is called the friction clutch. These are to be further categorized in the disc clutch, cone clutch, and integral clutch. And disc plate or plate clutch is further classified as a single plate clutch and multiple plate clutch. Okay. A good quality of clutch has basic purpose. The clutch should have the property of the gradual engagement. It should not engage the power suddenly, but it will gradual engagement of the driving shaft to the driven shaft. And the operation of the clutch should be requires very less power. That means the human beings just press the pedal should requires very less efforts. And the size of the clutch should be minimum so that it can be accommodated in any engines. And as for the inertia and mass to be concerned, there should be the minimum inertia, because after the disengaging the clutch, due to inertia, the clutch should not be run ideally. So the inertia is to be lower, and the mass is also lower, and torque transmission capacity is to be high, and friction capability is also high. Heat dissipation capacity of the clutch should be high, because as the clutch is engaged, a large amount of heat is to be generated, and that heat is further this heat has to be further dissipated properly. So a good clutch has a high heat dissipation capacity, and it should have the vibration and damping capacity as well. So these are the basic requirements of the good clutch. Now we will discuss the one single clutch, that is called the single plate clutch. The single plate clutch basically consists of the four basic components. One is called the pressure plate clutch. This is called the pressure plate. Another is called the clutch plate, and third one is the spring shunt, and the fourth one is the release fingers. This has to be further cleared with this particular diagram here. This one is the engines flywheels, and this one is the cover, clutch cover, and this one is the pressure plate. This is the pressure plate, and this one is the transmission shaft, which is going to the gearbox, and this one engine shaft, or this is called the crank shaft, and this one is the friction plates. So when we just raise the pedal, this friction plate, these friction plates are disconnected with the pressure plate as well as the viscous flywheel. That means that no power is to be transferred. Here, when we just remove the pedal, then there is a throw out bearing. With the help of this throw out bearing, the spring is to be expanded, and this pressure plate exert a pressure on this friction plate. As a result of this, there is a connection between the flywheel and the pressure plate. As a result of this, the friction is to be generated. That particular friction rotate the transmission, some power is to be transmitted. So here, as far as the pressure plates nature is to be concerned, there are steel plates. They are single disc clutch plate. The type of plate in which the single thin iron plate is to be coated with friction material on the both sides. This is the friction material. There is only one clutch plate in this type. Okay. The clutch plate is placed against the flywheels of the engine by the spring loaded pressure plates. The pressure produced by the number of spring located between the pressure plate and the housing, which is bolted to the flywheels, holds the friction surface firmly in contact. When the pedal of the clutch is depressed, the pressure plate is pushed back by the release fingers. That is, this is called the pressure plate, and this one is called the friction plate. So there is a friction lines are there. There is some springs is to be given. This is the helical spring. That helical spring is utilized for dampening the vibration impact at the engaging of the clutch. And another type of the clutch that is called the multi plate clutch. This is the another version of the single plate clutch, in which the plates are the multiple in number. So here this, as the we have already learned the single plate clutch, there is the alternate arrangement of the plate, the friction plates and the pressure plates. See, here this one is the pressure plate, this one is the pressure plate, and this one is the friction plates or friction lines. Okay, and this one is the spring. Okay, so as the clutch is to depress, all the friction plates come into contact with the pressure plate and below the flywheels. So they are engaging of this clutch plate to be done, and the power is to be transmitted. Such type of multiple plate clutch is to be utilized if the plate is withstand the higher amount of torque in lower space. If the single plates are not sufficient to deliver the amount of the torque, we require the more number of the plates. So in case of the scooter or the small two-wheelers, multiple plate clutches to utilize. So here you can see the exploded view of this multi-plate clutch. So here this is the arrangement of this with the pressure plate, ultimately simultaneously there is a friction plate, then pressure plate, friction plate, friction plate. These are arranged in such a fashion that will provide the high amount of the torque.
Let us see the one of the animation of the diaphragm type clutch. Here this diaphragm type clutch is basically, there is the two shaft. One is called the main shaft, this one is the main shaft, and this main shaft is connected with the engine, and this one is the output shaft, which is not connected with the engine because this is connected with the gearbox. Now here there is a bearing. That particular bearing is called the throwout bearing, and this throwout bearing pushes the diaphragm fingers, and this diaphragm finger presses the friction plate, which is mounted between the flywheels and the diaphragm housing. Okay, so when the pedal is not pressed, in that particular case there is engagement of the power is the flow. And here you can see this is the flywheels, and this flywheels is basically connected with the engine crankshaft. When the engine provides the power. This flywheel also rotates, and there are various bolt arrangement are to be given. So on this bolt arrangement, the diaphragm housing is to be mounted. Now there is another output shaft. This output shaft is connected with this friction plates. Or this is the friction plates, and this friction plates had the friction line over the annular sections of this particular plates. And over here you can see that both the shaft is running. That means that there is a direct contact of this flywheels with the friction plate. Now this one is the housing. This is the diaphragm housing. Here you can see that the power is to be transferred. That means the friction plate is connected with the flywheels. Now you can see here that there is no any movement of the power. The inlet side is powerless, and outlet is also powerless for showing the movement of this diaphragm. So here you can see the diaphragm is to be activated with the help of the throwout bearing, and this throwout bearing is to be operated with the help of the pedal. When we just depress the pedal, then the power connection is off. When you press the pedal, power connection. When you just release the pedal, the power connection has to be done. And this is the basic principle of diaphragm type of clutch.